12-minute 1v1's fair long, but let's pop straight into this one. Rainbrain versus Kira is our fourth 1v1, and I believe our last one as well. Urgot versus Kindred are the bans. We're gonna have to keep the hype train going, Yamato.
So Kira has been the guy that has been very outspoken in the videos we've seen from the CIS region. He's been saying that he wants to crush every mid laner in the tournament.
He also loves kangaroos, so there's a plus there.
Yeah, that's good too. But he hasn't said anything what he wants to do about junglers.
That's true. And Rainbrain, of course, jungler for the LDL team, the Japanese side. Kira, the CIS mid laner, who's been quite impressive all tournament long. We are pretty much done. Urgot, Caitlyn, Lulu banned out for Rainbrain. Kindred, Yorick, and Kennen, the bans there for Kira. And Lucian straight away locked in there for the CIS mid laner. And I know about this. So do you remember the Vladimir game from Evie? The reason Evie played Vladimir is because he wanted to play Pantheon. He said, only Pantheon. I will only play Pantheon. And it got banned. So I think Rainbrain might be trying to redeem the Japanese 1v1 side by playing Pantheon, or it's just the only thing they practice.
So picking Vladimir is basically waving a white flag.
It was a panic pick, you
surrender.
He's like, they banned Pantheon, I didn't know what to pick because I was only Pantheon. But now Rainbrain is continuing the only Pantheon tradition with it not banned away. This is going to be fun.
But Pantheon as well, he has that block, works perfectly against AD carries, which is something you should almost predict that anyone will pick in a 1v1.
And again, or is kind of a jungle champion, was at least at some point, so Rainbrain probably has some experience here. Interested to see Lucian, who's also very rarely, but sometimes a mid laner. So I imagine both these players are going to be fairly familiar with their champions.
It's going to be very interesting to see the choice of Keystone Masteries. I'm trying to think of it myself when it comes to Pantheon in this particular one. In Summoner's Rift, people usually go for the Warlord's one that whenever someone's low HP, you crit and you get health back. Works wonderfully, but on this map, it's kind of hard to think of anything.
Not a lot of crit going on, unless you have the 1% rune and you're hoping for a couple lucky crits there. I've seen a lot of Grasp of the Undying, I believe, just this morning, which has been kind of strange.
Does not apply on the spear, though.
No.
That is my concern, comparing it to the Gangplank.
I assume Pantheon's going forever at battle. I guess we're going to find out as we are going into the Snowdown Showdown. Corrupting Potion actually to start for Rainbrain. Doran's and some biscuits there for Kira. You can see spear already started. The plan is fairly straightforward for Pantheon, I think. Spear him. There we go.
Q, plan A. Q.
Yep.
And then just at some point, when he's low enough, just Spartans! And then just kick him into the pit.
Well, there's more Qs, but the early trade's going Kira's way with that piercing light, so Lucian Q, better level one than Pantheon Q. Both of them will go back. I think Kira has vision of this. I wonder if he'll cancel it. He will! And how minions have spawned. This is kind of awkward.
I think Kira should just stay and contest the wave as soon as it hits.
These mind games.
Rainbrain, I'm not sure why he didn't just pop a Corrupting Potion while he was trading. He would have regained the HP, sure, used one stack, but he would have done more damage.
Yeah, does pop it now, so it can start getting that Corruption going. As you can see, Kira in trouble there. You can see the Qs blocks that hit as well. So he's going to win some of these trades. Not going to hit level 2 that quickly, but does want to get the level 1 advantage ASAP. You can see Rainbrain is popping those potions. As Kira's trying to really get the wave and get that level 2. Lucian is so strong. There's so many different points in the game, but Rainbrain starting to win a lot of these early trades with that passive.
Well, it's very interesting that Kira went for the cleanse. Personally, I liked it a lot. I talked about it earlier. Cleanse against champions that have stuns, and of course, most players are going to go for the exiles and the ignite, so you can have it and use it very, very efficiently in this 1v1.
I feel like this is the matchup where it's really good. Like you said, it covers all the bases here, and he has an exhaust just in case for an all-in. So Kira, well set up as far as early choices go. It is blind pick, of course, so you just have to take your best guess. Rainbrain now going to struggle to last it under this tower, like we mentioned. And 11-3 already is at CS. Again, the AD carries get the early lead.
It's all about that 1v1, man. It's all about 1v1. Oh, I'm saying level 1.
Yeah, 1v1, level 1.
What I said made no sense.
I knew what you were talking about. It's okay.
Thank you, thank you.
And Rainbrain has added charges as well. He took a little too much damage in the early trade. So has chugged through all of his delicious potions. Kira's just going to keep pushing us in. I think we're going to have to wait for a recall here for Pantheon because he's just going to have to kind of hang out, wait for some gold. He didn't even get his health relic, so Kira really keeping him down here in this lane early on.
He's just going to keep doing this, keep hitting the Lucian Qs, and eventually Rainbow is going to have too low HP and just has to base.
Yep, might even die, unfortunately. We'll have
worst
to see.
Case scenario.
Kira has such a big CS lead. I mean, where is the window here for Pantheon? Is it that all in? I don't know what level specifically he might look for, but he definitely can't keep up on CS at this point.
Like, at this point, it is looking very, very grim. Like, that level 1 start when they were fighting each other and Rainbrain was not popping his potions, that was a very, very bad decision.
I feel like, yeah, if he'd gone in just aggressively, might have been okay with the potions, but instead the Doran's looking good for early stats here for Kira. Nice Q just on the end there for the damage, and just going to keep clearing waves out.
Because something that Pantheon also has going for him, like in that Lucian, when he's level 1, he doesn't have the E. Pantheon is a champion that has one of the highest base movement speeds in the game. He could have chased the Lucian down, kept popping those potions, maybe went for the full complete all-in.
Ooh, he's going to go for something here, but has to back away. Does actually use the exhaust. It's cleansed off. Kirov actually going to keep fighting in. Very aggressive. Ignite down now as well. Ravering going to make it close, but the damage is done. Kirov gets the kill.
Beautiful. I feel like he should have put something in the video about what he was going to do with the jungle as well, because that was utter domination.
Very well played by Kira. I think Rainbrain made a calculated risk there. He's like, I kind of have to all in at some point. Now's not a bad point. He actually picked a fairly good time, but Kira stayed calm, cleansed up the exhaust, waited out, let them kite it back to the minion wave.